WeatherWatch 12, brought to you by your local Chevy dealers. Step up to a rugged, long-lasting 2014 Chevy Silverado Double Cab with total savings up to $9,000. But hurry, an offer this good won't last long. Go with the leader. Go with Chevy.
Thanks for logging on to WISN.com. I'm meteorologist Chris Gloninger with this web weather update. Very complex weather map. A couple of areas of low pressure that we are tracking, one south of the Twin Cities, another one east of Wichita. And with it, a lot of rain. And in some cases, that rain started off in the form of wet snow as the column of air between the clouds and the ground warmed up. And those now flakes are up towards Green Bay and up towards Appleton. For the southeastern part of the state, it's rain now that we've warmed up above 32 degrees. Big spin in the atmosphere. You can see it on the radar and satellite, counterclockwise flow. Several waves of moisture moving in, pivoting in from the south. And that will continue through the course of the evening, overnight, and first part of our Tuesday morning. Still some wet snowflakes into Dodge, Fond du Lac, and western Sheboygan counties at this hour as of 4 o'clock. And that rain, sometimes heavy. You see these speckles of darker green indicating moderate to occasionally heavy rain. When all is said and done, about a half to three quarters of an inch of rain. This is at 11. We're seeing scattered showers. It fills in around 4 o'clock. And you see this band between Beaver Dam, Johnson Creek, West Bend, and Milwaukee. Those yellows indicating some downpours through 4 o'clock. And then things begin to taper off. For the drive into work, the steadiest rain is up towards Sheboygan and Fond du Lac counties. Residual showers will persist through at least 9 or 10 o'clock in the morning, even through noon. The latest future cast showing that down towards Milwaukee and Racine, we could see a sprinkle, same out towards Waukesha. Bigger picture showing low pressure to our south developing during the day on Wednesday. Showers at 8 o'clock in the morning. Watch what happens during the afternoon. That rain changes over to snow as the column cools. And this storm will actually produce its own cold air. So that cold air making its way from the clouds back down to the ground. So we're seeing this ribbon of snow in the backside of the storm that continues through 4, 5, 6, 7 o'clock. It winds down as low pressure begins to move out by 11 p.m. Christmas Eve. The snow will fall after sunset. So that's our best chance of seeing an accumulation. At this point, it's probably not going to be much. First, the rain, around a half an inch to three quarters of an inch, as we switch to our snow potential. Here it is. I'd say a quarter, 25% chance of an inch or more from Janesville through Johnson Creek, Beaver Dam, Waukesha County up through West Bend and Sheboygan, a 50% chance. The highest chance or the greatest chance of seeing an inch or more snow, the immediate lakeshore, including Ozaukee, Milwaukee, Eastern, Racine, and Kenosha counties. And this will be Wednesday afternoon and into the evening, something we're going to be watching very closely. Temperatures tomorrow actually into the mid-40s, a warm day on Tuesday. So Wednesday, the snow potential is there at 37 degrees. It's a cooler day for Christmas at 34. No real travel impacts. It will be dry with a mix of sun and clouds. Flurries around on Friday, and then cold weather returns for Saturday, Sunday, and Monday. High temperatures into the 20s to around 30. Thanks for logging on to WISN.com. Your next update is coming up later on this evening.